وحاصل العلم ما أمني الصفات له، فأرخ سمعك واستنصت إلى كلمي، وذاك لا حفظك الفتيا بأحرفها ولا بتسويدك الأوراق بالحمم.
المعقد الخامس, the fifth chapter, and that is سلوك الجادة الموصلة إليه. Knowledge, it has its path. And so in this chapter we're going to be talking about the path to knowledge. Some people, they may say, everyone has their own path to knowledge. We can take it in our way. I'm going to try and test. When we know that the scholars of the past, they had their path to knowledge. And their path to knowledge was the same path that the scholars before them, they took. And so this path to knowledge is the only way that a person is actually going to gain that knowledge. If a person tries to take and try and, you know, trials and does trial and error, you know, he goes to another path and he sees, maybe I can get knowledge from this path, he's never going to get it. So what is that path to knowledge? الزبيدي رحمه الله تعالى, he says, فما حوى الغاية في ألف سنة شخص فخذ من كل فن أحسنه بحفظ متن جامع للراجح تأخذه على مفيد الناصح. He said, no one has gained the end of knowledge, even in 1,000 years. You're never going to get to the end of knowledge. So take from every fan, every subject, the best. Okay? But how? By memorizing a matan, memorizing a book, number one, memorizing. Number two is that it is a matan that is used by the people of knowledge. Don't try to invent your own book. Learn the books that the people of knowledge before they learnt. Right? But also you have to take it from a person of knowledge. تأخذه على مفيد. Take it from someone who is beneficial to you. And he is ناصح. He is someone who wants good for you. So this it goes back to four things. Taking the right path of knowledge goes back to four things. Number one, it is to memorize a matan, a book that is it encompasses all of that knowledge. You learn the books that the people they learnt. So for example, when it comes to Arabic, the people in the past, they learnt Alfiyat ibn Malik, right? So learn Alfiyat ibn Malik. Or Al-Ajrumiyyah, they start with Al-Ajrumiyyah. When it comes to fiqh, they have steps of books that you need to learn. Learn those books, but also you need to memorize. Memorizing is an important part of knowledge, my brothers and sisters. Because when it comes to memorizing, you realize that it stays with you for a long time and it keeps that knowledge firm in your head. So whenever you need it, all you need to do is remember those things that you memorized and you got that knowledge back. You remember it, right? So you need to memorize. And the thing that you need to memorize, it needs to be something that was memorized by the people of the past. Number two is فَأَخْذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحٍ. You take this knowledge from a person who is beneficial. He's beneficial. So mufid. What does it mean by beneficial? He's a person who has sought knowledge. You don't take knowledge from everyone and anyone. Some of the Salaf, they used to say, لَا يُؤْخَذُ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا أَمَّنْ عُرِفَ بِالطَّلَبِ. You don't take knowledge except from someone who was known to have sought knowledge. You don't take knowledge from everyone. You have to, the person who you're taking knowledge from is someone who was known in his community to be a student of knowledge when he was growing up. And when he grew up, his mashayikh, his teachers, they said that this person is suitable to teach. That is the person you need to seek knowledge from. And number two, he is nasih. He can be knowledgeable, yes, but he also needs to give you what you need. He needs to be sincere, he needs to have sincerity for your sake. He gives you your knowledge according to what you need, not according to what you want. For example, you find that a person, he has knowledge, so he wants to research himself on Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, 50 volume books of a hadith. So because of his research, he goes to a young student of knowledge who hasn't learned anything. He said, come, let's study Musnad al-Imam Ahmad. What is he doing it for? Is he doing it for the student or is he doing it for himself? He's doing it for himself, right? So this teacher, as a teacher, you need to be someone who's not looking, you're not looking at yourself. You're looking at the student. What does the student need? ولذلك الإمام محمد إبراهيم آل الشيخ, a student came to him, reading to him a book, learning from him a book. And whilst reading the book to him, he made a mistake in Arabic. He said to him, have you studied Arabic? He said, no. He said, stop reading this book to me. Come and we'll start Ajrumiyyah, we'll start Al-Nahu, learning about grammar. Right? So this is a person who's sincere. He wants him to learn. When students will come to him and they haven't memorized the Quran, he'll say to him, don't come to me, go memorize the Quran, then you can come to me and seek knowledge. Why? If he wants, he can have a whole gathering of thousands of students. But he's sincere, he wants the student to learn. So he gives him what he needs, not necessarily what he wants, right? So this is the student, this is the way of knowledge. It is number one, you're memorizing books. and you're learning it from the people of knowledge, and you're memorizing the correct books, and you're learning it from a person who is suitable to teach and has given you sincere advice, sincerity to his students. No doubt it is beneficial to know one subject and to be specialized in one subject. But the meaning of specialization that we have today is a problematic meaning. And that is that people, they assume that specialization is for a person to know one type of knowledge, one subject. He doesn't know any other subject. Like I mentioned, he only knows fiqh. Only knows Quran and Qira'at, nothing else. He doesn't know the meanings, he doesn't know tafsir. All he knows is just how to read. فيا سائلا عن منهج الحق يبتغي سلوك طريق القوم حقا ويسعد تأمل هداك.
How will you answer the questions on the day of judgment if you don't know the answers? كان للحق يقصد نقر بأن. This is why the hadith mentions that seeking knowledge is obligatory on every single Muslim. Knowledge is how you will survive that day. Knowledge is a Muslim's survival guide.
Assalamu alaikum. I've got a quiz for you. This quiz, very simple, but the prize is big, inshallah ta'ala. Okay, let me ask you questions. Three questions, inshallah ta'ala. Question number one. What does Allah's name, Allah, mean? Question number one. Question number two. What is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's full name? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the beginning. What's the rest of his name sallallahu alayhi wasallam? The third question is, when you go to the toilet and when you're doing tahara and you're using tissue paper to wash yourself, what is the minimum number of tissue paper wipes that you must wipe yourself with as a bare minimum that you have to do? Simple questions, right? If you have the answer to all three, then that means inshallah ta'ala, you know Allah to some extent, you know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to some extent, and you know Islam to some extent. But if you became confused with these very basic questions, then as a brother, I have to ask you right now to really just take a step back and pause. In life, you've learned things like trigonometry in mathematics that have never benefited you most likely since the day you left uni. You've read Shakespearean literature, or perhaps you read Of Mice and Men. What bearing did that have in your life? You've studied photosynthesis and all of these different isms and schisms at school. And you've been doing so for the last decade plus. When did you take out the time to learn about your religion? When did you take out the time to learn about your Lord? When did you take out the time to learn about His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam? When have you taken out the time to learn about your deen? These are basic things that are obligatory for every single Muslim to know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, طَلَبَ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. Seeking knowledge is obligatory upon every single Muslim, one Muslimatin and every single Muslim woman. You need to know this stuff. Allah created you to know this stuff. What is the evidence Allah created you to know this stuff? He created you so that you can worship Him alone, as He said in Surah Al-Dhariyat. How can you worship Him without knowing who He is? And how can you worship Him without not knowing how to worship Him? The study of Aqidah and the study of Fiqh. This is essential, brothers and sisters. And a person is sinning if they don't know this. And how will they pass the questions within the grave? I told you three simple questions, but the prize is massive. The prize, if you can understand the answers to the three questions in the grave properly, you will have the prize of paradise. Brothers and sisters, at this stage, I'd like to advise you to just take a pause for a second. I told you years you've been studying secular things. Take out 1 year of your life, part-time, just 4 hours a week to learn about the absolute basics of your deen. We have a program called the Muslim Survival Guide. It is what the title insinuates. It's a guide that will show a Muslim how to survive. Survive what? The questioning within the grave. And the questioning on the Day of Judgment, inshallah ta'ala. If you take out 4 hours a week, inshallah, you're going to learn the basics of your deen. You want to carry on after that? Fantastic. But if all you want to do is take out this, at least you've got the basics. Now, it is a 1-year program, and it's being taught not just by myself, but multiple Knowledge College teachers. We have myself, Ustad Yasin, we have Ustad Abdul-Ahad, and others. You can check on the page in the description below by scrolling down to see who the teachers are. We'll be teaching you, connecting with you personally, teaching you life. It's not just going to be audio and video. No, you will actually be communicating with us, inshallah ta'ala, in a class. But now, I have to mention something. There is a tuition fee for the program. Of course, to run the Knowledge College, as you know, it requires us to have finances. So for that reason, we have a tuition fee. But when you look at university, where you spend £9,000 a year, or when you look at other institutes that are even Islamic institutes, where they'll charge you £3,000 a year, our fee is going to be only £75 a month. That's it. £75 a month throughout the academic year. It's not even a complete year. 38 weeks, £75 a month. But I must bring something to your attention. The spaces are extremely limited. We've packed out already one class and we're on the brink of packing out the second. So make use of this offer right now. £75 a month. It's only available here. The other students were paying £150. But you have it at this amazing offer right here, right now. And we're giving it to you before we put it out on the rest of my social media, before we give everyone else that last final chance to access it. So I'm really excited to have you on board the Muslim Survival Guide. Don't let shaitan get in the way right now. Just commit for 1 year, 38 weeks, learn about your deen and take that space before someone else takes it. And that's it. You're going to be with the Knowledge College teachers throughout the academic year. Sign up at the link below. Assalamu alaikum. Peace.